And of the seven lineal practices here, the first practice will be the requesting not to pass away or not to enter into parinirvana. The reason being that in order to accumulate merit and in order to purify the negativities, and then spiritual guides or lamas need to live in a very long, without them, and then there's no much to be done in the spiritual. For this reason, the requesting not to pass away is absurd in the first place.
Today, in that day, it's all sabishin to lama yuri to juro is the Nagali Medal sort of Pian Tamu Juha, the Chugi Nay Chamber, the days, the subject is real.
And the reason and the requesting not to pass away is not insert in the first place is because the it is very important about the gurus. Because there are these serious the importance in the Dharma Dharachita Manis and Guru Yoga, the requesting not to pass away is used as a first practice of the seven winter practices, and also in the Guru Yoga of Somgundu and the Avalokiteshvara freeing all the bad migrations also used also practice this not to pass away of the seven practices.
And the
next is that we should offer lion thrones mentally and to each of the the spirit of the Chesongkhapa and his two spiritual sons in order to remain for a long time. If we can't do this mental transformation, then if we have mandala base, we should then five marks on the top of the the mandala base, four on each direction, and one in the center. And think that one has then offered this snowy lion thrones and to Jetsongkhapa and his two spiritual sons. We should visualize that in the space before us, and then Jetsongkhapa and his two spiritual sons are sitting on a lion throne. And online throne, then we should visualize the lotus, and then in the moon, and they think that venerable Jetsongkhapa's two spiritual sons are smiling with delight. In some tankas, we can see just Jetsongkhapa sitting on the throne, but his two spiritual sons are just sitting on the two soft cushions, but that's slightly wrong. So what we should do is we should visualize all of three, Jetsongkhapa and his two spiritual sons, were actually sitting on the lion throne.
Dalu tebe suna shinju suda ngay be teba jasakite suna sobe shing pena maranzo shingarwa shinga dantando dantando ragarwa pya na jengi be rando suna sosa shingarwa lamari lamari be suna sobe shincho neza suna sobe shingi shok suna sobe shing soshin sayunwa jen sosa sabi shing dalu tebe suna shincho do ta Bekeva Jata Mambu, but the Juro Naja, Juro Gubaka, yes, and the Nate, Betan to Jurochi, Nasuna Sabi Shimicho to Jurochi, Temba Jevet to Jurochi. Oh, not Sija Tajila, Dijon, the Temple Aleva. Here's the Temba Jevet, Chet Bekeva Jata Jurochi, Temba Jevet to Juro, Sija Dijon to Juro, Chivari, to that area.
And then we should say, as the supreme and the merit of field for my in the mind of faith. I request you to remain for 100 eons to spread in the teaching. And just as from the field, we can reap, we can receive the crops. In a similar way, Jetsongkhapa and his two spiritual sons were like a field to in order to accumulate in a merit. And think that and. Remain, you three remain within me in order to develop faith and for the sake of sentient beings and for the sake of surviving the Buddha Dharma and sentient beings and happiness and so forth depends on the Buddha's teachings. So you please remain with us for the sake of the Buddha Dharma and the happiness and the faith of ours.
Tenpa je se te je ju su su. Ta shi je shi, ta yin la dung nam jing li sung wa. Yang ga ni min dao suwa daba ding li sung wa.
Open the seven limited practices we have now, finished one.
Yang ga ni min dao suwa daba da chung wu ga yin la ni la.
And it is said when we make a request to not to pass away and to turn the wheel of Dharma, mentally we should imagine they accepted it not to pass away and to give the teaching. And if we do it, and then it makes a very auspicious sign to be happy. Now follows the practice and in practices of prostrate, which begins opens like this. Your intelligent mind comprehends the vast range of objective knowledge. Your speech of good explanation is the ear ornament for those of good fortunes. Your beautiful inner body is radiant with the glory of fame. To you, whom to behold, hear, and remember is a meaningful, I prostrate.
And when
we do this guru yoga, it is we can generate ourselves as a deity, or we can stop generate ourselves as being a deity. In probably one of the collected works of Gundam. There is teachings of generating oneself as the yamataka, instantly having having dissolved everything into the emptiness. From within this emptiness, then one should generate as deity yamataka, and then one should do this the his practice of the hundreds of deities of the land of joy, but even it's up to one's hand whether one be generated by a seventh deity as one's as a deity or without it. But anyway, now the first line, your intelligent mind comprehends the vast range of object knowledge and reveals the good quality of the mind. Whoever we visualize about any guru or spiritual guide, and then we should visualize his body is permeated or is pervaded throughout the world. And this is a very difficult one to be realized. And in some texts, it says that all these all the pure lands dissolved into or completes into the body. If possible, and then we should visualize the pure lands, different pure lands on the on the hair paw of the Jetsongkhapa, and we do have hair paws, and for some people there are two hairs on the growing from hair paw, and the Buddhas that we have only one eye, the hair growing from hair paw, and curling in clockwise, and the each of this hair paw, and then one should visualize many the Buddha lands, and in there, and then one should visualize that the deity and the Buddha, Bodhisattvas, and also if possible, we should visualize the Buddhas who are residing there on the pure lands. We should also visualize their lives, what they have done before they were actually the rich, before they were actually enlightened being. What we should also visualize that what they have, the substance they offered before they became the Buddha, such as cloth and other articles they use in order to create a merit. So if possible, then we should visualize the experience on the hair pores, and imagine that these Buddha lands are not becoming smaller.
Sajje, 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 Sajje energy on go at Amato Jinx at my young in the jail. Some you may say the Jibar is your. That's a good one. Jenny Chandayori. Sabuva Yunguya de Suyanda Biroji when his gender Zeva Yinza Gualani to Totashima Rangrizi on the Toxan. Ordinated that Russia and Jung Chimmy Shepherd, she has hired and yet hired your money, because you could say your name now. Georgi or Kaljo Yuri, Josame.
And even in the Bodhisattva who's on the tent ground do have you know this the powers to emanate you know the purulence of the hair paws. And it is said you know that the Bodhisattva who's on the tent ground is Buddha but not the complete you know the Buddha. So there is like this discussion. The reason being that the pretend Bodhisattva tent ground do have you know the equal and similar the understanding and attainments to the complete or the full awakening of the Buddhas. That's why they said and the tenth ground is the Buddha, is a Buddha, but not a complete the Buddha because he is not completed you know, the attainments of what the fully enlightened being has achieved. And there are many the things to be discussed about these the grounds, about the eight grounds of the Hinayana system and so forth. And it's very important to know this, but maybe it seems that you are not receiving this in the teachings on this, and the Vishalas do have the recitations or memorize all this, you know, the qualities of the, you know, the different grounds of the Bodhisattvas.
All the things that you have to do with your own, the Sanjay is a good thing. The Jay is a good thing. Janju Simba Sai, and there's a son of Don Shen, Yabu Yodis, that is Shimo Kawore. In a Dunji, somebody gave Pui Babu Kamore, another Sanji Shinapatu, where you they can do. That's some of Don Madina. Rangi Chat said a good Rangi Chat said, No one used to go with Chats and Sugi watching the sugar. No one used to be charged.
And now the follows about the prostration. And we recite here, you know, that saying, I respect, respectfully, I prostrate to you three, you know, the doors. And and there are many ways of making the prostrations, such as verbal and so forth, and that you do. But physical prostrations find it difficult for you, and you just, you know, just sit, you know, there without actually making the full length in the prostrations. And in accordance with the, you know, Vinaya, and the two prostrations are mentioned. One is bent, and then next is outstretched prostrations. If one cannot make actually full kind of prostrations or outstretched prostrations, at least physically one should make folded hands at our heart when we do make prostrations. And this outstretched, so the outstretched, you know, the prostration is not made in accordance with the Vinaya. And there's another in the prostration known as Yabujivicha, and that you don't know how to do it.
Yabu Majidagi Sanjay. Yabu Majida Lanchin Shun Pagre. Lanchin Shun and Budu, a Sanjay to pay a time, Muni, Kore Rison, Lamsa Lanchamalwa, Chungja Jabazuru, Korama Risho, Kore Luxu, Sanjay Javataga, Tashan Yun, Lanchin Shun, Lamsa de Ramarin, Ritong, Sadikonma, Ribri, the Deguma, Sanjay Kishin Lubu, Sanjay Dubuyoma.
And this, sorry, now Jabu Jiva means the prostration of, you know, the lying down by the king. This you can't do it because when you know, the king Ajatashatra used to ride on an elephant, and when he saw the Buddha, he immediately, you know, get off, you know, and fell onto, you know, the ground. But he's never, you know, injured, and he's never, you know, destroyed.
And
then the Ajatashatra said, when I hear about you, I, you know, raise my hands, and physically I pay some kind of you know, the respect. And then his, you know, the disciples Buddha asked the questions, is the raising hands and so forth, is are the prostrations. And Buddha said, not actual prostration, but it is the, you know, the manner of paying respect. Now, if we make, you know, the outstretched prostrations, and then we should do it because we receive, you know, the more the merits. If we can't do outstretched prostration, then we should do in a bent one, a bent prostration, touching the five limbs of the body on the ground. And this the five limbs, we say that five limbs, but two in the feet already touch on the ground, and at the same time we need to touch the two knees on the ground. And then another two limbs are the two palms of the hand should be touched on the ground. And the fifth one is that our forehead should be touched on the ground. And some people just they bow down and they try to, they don't touch their forehead on the ground, just, you know, do it like this on the ground, but actually they don't touch the ground. If they don't touch their forehead on the ground, then that is not a prostration. And some people just touch the two, you know, the hands on the ground, but not the two knees.
And
And when we said that we should touch, you know, the, all these five limbs on the ground, some people may think that it should be complete on the, you know, solid in the ground. And so some people maybe think that we have to remove the carpets. So it's not necessary, you know, that we can just, you know, the touch on the ground of the carpet is laid on. It doesn't matter, just touch on where we are making the prostration.
And
when we in the making of prostrations, be it bent or outstretch, we should, you know, they do like this, with, you know, while not closing our fingers in the palm, and the, you know, the, some people when they finish the outstretch of or, you know, the bend and the prostration, and when they are getting on, and then they, you know, close their fingers like this, and then this is incorrect to
it.
And some people, when they make, you know, prostration, so land outstretched prostration, and then just lay down on the ground. They don't even care about, you know, lay down on the ground, then they even talk to another in the colleagues. So it's not good, you know, to be there on the ground for a long time. A long time. So as soon as you finish touching the ground, you should get up.
When
we say I respectfully I prostrate to you with the three doors, and if we cannot make an outstretched prostrations, and then we should we should make folded hands physically at our heart, and then we should slightly bend our head or incline our the head towards the front, and then this is sufficient. Making the physical prostrations, and as for the verbal prostration, we should say the praise to the, you know, the object of refuge, then this is a verbal prostration, and then developing devotion and faith in the, you know, the objects of, you know, the prostration. I think that you all know everything what I do, and they rely completely on the objects of refuge is then in the mental prostration.
And
So next is now about an offering, if we visualize the offerings very extensively, then it is a little bit complicated and difficult for us to do it. But anyway, some people, what they do is they try to visualize the atoms, giving this sun atoms which are the sun rays. In the Buddha land, on each of these small atoms, then they visualize Buddha land, and on the Buddha land, and then they visualize the Buddhas and other Buddha sattvas, and just as there are countless atoms in this world, so too they visualize countless Buddha lands and the Buddhas, and when they visualize these countless Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, and then the Buddhas and the Buddha lands does not become smaller, the atoms does not become bigger in this way, and then they make offerings to this Buddha and Buddha lands. We cannot do this, but what we can do is that from the hair pose of the Jetsankhapa and his two spiritual sons who are in the space for us, the center lights and it's many lights, and each on the tip of each lights, and then one should visualize the Buddha land and the Buddhas residing there, and then one should and at the same time one should emanate many replica of one's body, and then one should imagine that one's making an offerings to these Buddhas who are residing in the countless Buddha lands.
Sanje namba nanze thoba kanchen so syaji ore.
There is one the Buddha known as Thoba Kanchen. So,
ode daja gitamba shaja thoba gu chuji gi longu tu jato.
It is this the basis for the emanating Shakyamuni Buddha, which is Thoba Kanchen. So it's the internal body which is the basis for emanating Shakyamuni Buddha.
Kaise chugu re songu do te kaino. Thoba nanama de kanchen so singe sanje de kuzu chumu yonda. Kuzu ge babu kumbu re sanje ge shinga re yori.
And some people say that this Thoba Namna Kanchen Tso is an emanation body, but it's the enjoying body, which is who's the basis of emanating Shakyamuni Buddha. And this Buddha Kanchen Thoba Namna Kanchen Tso is very tall. On each of these, each of the hair poses of this Thoba Buddha Thoba Namna Kanchen.